So even though today is the 1st of April, this is no joke. This is the last video I thought I'd be making. Believe me, I would much rather be making more videos as I experiment with time lapses and slow motions. But the reason for this video is to explain what's been going on for the last few weeks, and to say thank you to some special people. So the bottom line is, doctors are pretty sure that I've got a cancerous growth on my pancreas. This all started about 3 weeks ago when I started feeling sick, and then I noticed that my urine had gone dark and it was hurting to pee. So that's when I went off to the local doctor, the GP. They thought that maybe I had a urinary infection, started me onto my antibiotics and took some blood tests as a precaution. When we went back to the doctor a couple of days later, I was expecting them to say, keep taking the antibiotics and you'll be fine. But instead they said, your liver function is off the chart and straight to hospital for you. So I went to Dandenong Hospital and they did some tests. We started with an ultrasound, because the symptoms that I had were along the lines of gallstones. So we had an ultrasound, but that ruled out gallstones. Then we had a CT scan, which is when they discovered a growth on my pancreas. Now they wanted to do more scans, but they couldn't do it at Dandenong. They needed specialist equipment and the specialist doctors that were at Monash Clayton. So I was transferred there. So my symptoms were, as I said, my urine was dark. It was quite often hurting to pee and my skin was itchy everywhere. And apparently what's happened is that the growth on the head of my pancreas was compressing against the bile duct. Now the bile duct normally flows into your bowel to help break down fatty foods, but with this growth compressing the bile duct, that bile was just going throughout my body and causing the itchiness and also throwing out my liver function, which was making my urine dark and hurting to pee. Once I was at Monash Clayton, doctors organised a specialist MRI scan on my pancreas, which confirmed that there was a growth, and doctors were 95% certain that that's cancerous. The only way they could be 100% would be to take a biopsy and send it to the lab. But in any case, they needed to do something because it's compressing my bile duct and causing all these symptoms. Now, at the moment, this growth is 2.2 centimeters by 2.7, and another measurement took it as 2.6 centimeters across. So we're talking about a square inch of most likely cancerous growth. So tomorrow, Tuesday, I'll be in surgery. Now this is pretty full on. What the doctors need to do is slice my pancreas, take away about a third of it, the head of the pancreas, and along with that, a section of the bile duct and a section of the bowel that leads from the stomach to the small intestine. They will then need to, part of that as well will be removing the gallbladder. Obviously, once they've done all that, they need to put everything back together again. So they'll need to stretch out some of my small intestine, about 70 centimeters worth, which they tell me is fine because you've got 4 to 5 meters of small intestine, and fashion that in a way that we won't get reflux or anything, and plumb all that back together in a new way so the bile duct is flowing into the bowel again, and hopefully make a full recovery. Now your pancreas is what creates your insulin, so there might be some diabetes issues afterwards, but they're pretty confident that it won't be because the insulin is produced at the tail of the pancreas, whereas it's the head that they need to remove to get rid of all this cancerous growth. Now the operation tomorrow is all going well, 6 to 8 hours. If there's any complications, it could be longer. I am thankful that the doctors have let me come home for a week, because I spent 10 days between the two hospitals undergoing various tests and procedures. So it was good to be able to come home. It was actually my daughter's birthday this week as well, so I was home for that, which I'm thankful for. But tomorrow morning, we've got to be at the hospital at 7 a.m. and they said they'll have me in surgery or in theatre by 7:30. Giving us a week at home also allowed the doctors and surgeons to clear a whole day for me. So they're all taking this pretty serious as well. So that's what's been happening. The other part of this video is that I want to thank everybody, friends and family from literally all around the world that have reached out, commented, texted, messaged, or come to visit, or called. I really, really appreciate it. Friends and family that have helped out my wife and kids by making us dinners and helping out wherever else you can, thank you so much. I know it's been hard on the family as well, but my wife Mandy is awesome. The kids have been strong. So thank you to everyone. And I'm talking everyone, people that I haven't seen or spoken to for years, people I went to school with. It's been awesome to catch up, and I really appreciate your best wishes. Special thanks to Mandy's employer and my employer for being so understanding, keeping the money coming in. That's been really important. One less thing to worry about. So that's it. Like I said, I would much rather be making videos about time lapses that I've been experimenting with, or just vlogging, or just whatever, both on this channel and on my daughter's channel where we do playground reviews and things. Much rather be doing that than having to make a video like this, but I felt I needed to update everyone on what's been going on. But that doesn't mean while I was in hospital I wasn't thinking about being creative and making videos. A lot of the time I was nil by mouth and couldn't eat, but when that little sign above the bed was turned around and I could have a regular diet, I decided to take some footage of the meal that was presented to me, and I put together this little montage of hospital food. A little bit at the end there was some get well soon drawings from my 10-year-old daughter Carla. Thank you. To everyone else, thank you for watching, thank you for understanding, and thank you for your support. The next video I make will be an update on how everything's gone, but that's probably 3 weeks away. I'm going to be in hospital for at least 2 weeks recovering from the surgery, and then a couple of weeks at home just taking it really easy. But I will make an update video, hopefully to say that everything's gone well. Anyway, big day tomorrow. I'll see you soon. Thanks.